Are you going to write another volume of memoirs, like With Nails, which was a fantastic book?
Oh, thank you. Well, I write every day. You know, I keep a diary. But
so the answer is yes.
You don't want to annoy people.
Oh, well, I'd love it.
I've always known that, Uncle Bryn.
Thank you. Oh, that's Richard. If we ever email, he always begins it, "Hello, Uncle Bryn."
How can I not? That Christmas special, we literally watched it. I think we watched it on repeat that night that it came out. You know, along with the entire nation, we are very, very grateful to you. So,
well,
it's just one of the great joys that you brought us.
It's very, very kind of you to say, Richard, and I'll tell you for why.
No kind.
I've always been an enormous fan, not just me, but Nessa, everyone down in Barry is a fan, and we all found you particularly frightening in Star Wars: The Rise of Skywalker. Now, that must have been, I mean, I thought Sex and the City was a hoot, but that must have been an absolute hoot for you to do.
It was hilarious, Uncle Bryn. Yeah, what was so extraordinary about it is that I got sent an interrogation scene from clearly a B-feature 1940s war movie of about 12 pages, interrogating somebody and catching them out, which I self-taped, sent off. I didn't know what it was for. And then 2 months later, my agent called and said, they're sending a car for you to go and meet the director, producer at Pinewood Studios. And I said, I have no idea what this is for. And they said, no, you did a screen test. And I said, no, I didn't, for Star Wars. And I said, I didn't. So she had to then resend it to me so that I could know what I was talking about. And then when I got there, Nina Gold, the casting director, was waiting at the door, and she looked very excited, and she said, oh, you're about to go and meet the man himself. So I walked in there, and Daisy Ridley was sitting with him, and I thought, oh, this is one of those situations where I'm being asked to, which had happened before about 20 years ago, read in for some other actor who was up for the part, of something. So J.J. Abrams was incredibly friendly. And within about 2 minutes, he said to me, so you're going to do the part. And at that point, it felt like the room literally went upside down. And I don't really remember much of what he talked about for the next hour and a half. He told me what the plot was. He told me what my character was. I didn't remember any of that at all.
And the experience of doing it, how many physical sets were there, or was it mostly green screen?
You walked onto that, onto the deck.
Really?
That, all the corridors, all those doors, are everything was real. The stormtroopers, there was nothing CGI. So for a Star Wars fanatic, you know, I'd seen the first one when I was a 20-year-old drama student in 1977.
Yeah.
And if you had told me that, you know, 40 umpteen years later, I would actually be in the final one.
Yeah,
I just couldn't believe it.
And a great part as well.
And I was convinced I was going to be cut out or fired.